Hello guys, this is Timur Fearless, and today we're having part 2 of a view of Hypershell Exoskeleton. Now we are doing experiment 3-4 times harder than the hyper mode. Don't need an e-bike now. It's easier. Actually enjoying biking now. It really pushes my legs. Let's go! And today I'm gonna try to use it with this bicycle. My first ever food delivery is on bicycle. I'm too lazy to use it with my own legs. I use a Hypershell 1 horsepower AI exoskeleton for this one. And let's see how I'm gonna feel, how many orders I can make using only Hypershell and regular push bike. Let's go! So we're turning it on. We are logging into the Hypershell app. Now in eco mode. And the adaptive mode recognition. So if I will go on a bicycle, it should show that I'm cycling. And also I will try to put it manually to cycling mode. First, let's do it automatic and in the eco mode. And let's put the Strava app on. Let's put in e-bike because I don't know, is it considered e-bike or normal bike? What do you guys think? What should I put, like normal bike or e-bike? Let's go online in the Volt app. So I'm trying first time now. The Hypershell is on, and let's try to put legs so that it doesn't go off. Okay, success. So you can sit on. I haven't been riding a bike for years. It's so interesting. Can I still? Oh. Okay. All right. Oh wow. I can actually feel that he's helping me. Wow, it's easier, like for real. It's becoming like an e-bike. I wasn't expecting that it works so well. Most of the power it puts when I push a leg down. So then I feel like pressure that he's helping me to push down. Wow, okay, now it's on cycling mode and eco. Let's try. Okay, so it's now even more helping. No way, it's actually helping. Wow. Oh, it helps a lot. Oh my god, it's going faster. It helps me go faster. Actually transforms normal bike to e-bike. I don't feel tired riding bicycle. Now it's turned off. Oh, it immediately feels like it's harder. Yeah, it's definitely more effort. Wow. Let's try now the hyper mode. This is like the most powerful mode. And oh, I feel immediately power. Oh my god. It's like pushing himself. So easy. It adapts on the speed. If I go faster, then it pushes faster. Oh, wow. I can go so fast. The good thing is that I don't feel it, that it's on me. In this position, I don't feel any discomfort or that I'm wearing some exoskeleton. I'm actually enjoying biking now, like I enjoyed walking in the previous video. So let's try to do some orders. Let's try to catch some old orders, go more in the dense area now with the bicycle. Let's go! Got the first order. Yeah, nice. Let's go make some money. So it really pushes my legs instead of me. I'm not doing any effort, but it pushes my legs by myself. Wow, that's so easy. It accelerates itself. Even if I go, I need to brake in order to brake on the bicycle. That's too bad I don't see the speedometer actually, what speed I'm going. But it's very interesting to know. So then I try to take my leg off. All good. No issues. Let's put it on alarm. Nice. It lifting my legs by itself. So funny. So we're getting the first order. The hyper mode is crazy. Pick up the task and then we go. So now it's showing 4 minutes until the drop off. So let's see how fast we go from here. It's showing 1.2 kilometers. So let's go. But so far I'm actually enjoying riding the bicycle. But I think hyper mode is too fast. I need to put brakes in order to it not push too fast for me. So I'm now in the hyper mode and I feel like the hyper mode gives the most. It pushes my leg by its own. So you need to give the first push and then it pushes itself. So I don't feel any like tension or something. So unusual to work in the perspective of bicycle rider. So this like regular e-bike rider, do we try to catch him? We are just chilling here on the bridge with the Hypershell. Where I now lock it. Okay, let's try to lock it there. I never locked a bike. All right. Takes so much time with the locking. Of course, I could use the alarm, but I want to see how it's working with this. So it's something like this. Well, it's not so bad, but it works. Let's now go and deliver it. Now we're going to the elevator. Old Finnish elevators. This is a 1949 year elevator. 75 years old almost. All right, now we're walking to the customer. You hear the sound? So we're taking off the lock. Now we can continue. Maybe we get another good order there. It's always tricky. Today is really good weather for biking. It's quite enjoyable. No effort at all. But you don't need an e-bike now. Like for real. And it's 100% legal. Unicycle guy was like in shock. Why I'm riding bicycle today. So let's test the max speed of the Hypershell. 22, 27. Well, you can easily go 25 and it helps. Wow. Let's take it easier, like this. Let's try to go to 30. But the most comfortable is like 18 kilometers per hour. Oh, I'm getting already sweaty. Without the Hypershell, I immediately feel the tension in the knees when I'm pushing the bicycle, and I feel tiredness in the knees. So now is my leg power. Oh, now it's maybe about 25. More. So I got the order, now we deliver it. It's showing 1 kilometer. So we're putting the Hypershell on, the eco mode. So we need to go to the 7th floor. The elevator is taken, so it's faster to go by foot. But let's first put the hyper mode on. Let's go. Upstairs. Yeah. Ooh, 71%. Doing it this way. 7th floor, easy peasy. Perfecto. So guys, I tested the Hypershell now for 2 hours. My conclusions are that if you have several batteries, you can use the hyper mode, then it completely feels like electric bike. If you use eco mode, you can use it like for whole shift, at least I think 4 hours. Also, you can combine it with stairs or anything else. Yeah, you can save on an e-bike and just buy a Hypershell Exoskeleton. So it's interesting experience, but I think for the hyper mode, it needs to be more tweaked and get more battery or something like that. Alright guys, now we are doing experiment how much pulse will be with the Hypershell Exoskeleton and without. going uphill on our push bike. We're gonna measure it using Hypershell and without it and compare. First, I will use the hyper mode, the most powerful mode. Let's go! Starting pulse is 82 beats per minute, 948. All right, let's go. Trying to breathe evenly, not going too fast, and we are stopping here and measuring the pulse. 114 from the 82. So now I'm testing the eco mode. My pulse is 82 now. Let's go! Feels like two times harder that I have to push with the eco mode on, but it still feels, I think, lighter than I would push it myself. Trying to breathe evenly. Measuring, showing 123. It was about 5 to 10 beats per minute lower in the hyper mode. So this is interesting, yeah. Now I'm back and I'm waiting until my pulse is back to 82. So it's the same conditions, now it's 87, 89, 83. Okay, let's go. Without the Hypershell. Trying to keep the same tempo. It's definitely like two times harder than the eco mode and three, four times harder than the hyper mode. 124, 129, stop. So we have 129. So the difference is significant. 20 beats per minute. The uphill, it definitely helps with the pulse. Same condition, same start, same speed. 82, from 82 beats per minute. On one hill, it goes up to 134 without it, and 114 on the maximum mode. This was a nice experiment. You know that this is now working good for bicycles, and you can definitely transform your regular push bike to an e-bike thanks to Hypershell. So see you in my next videos, and let's go!